A child is standing in front of a straight plane mirror. His father is standing behind him, as shown in the figure. The height of the father is double the height of the child. What is the minimum length of the mirror required so that a child completely see his own image and his father's image in the mirror? So given that the father height is 2h, this is the father, ma, father height is 2h, and this is the person, means that child, the height of the child is half of the father, means that this is going to be h. So now condition is that he has to see the child image as well as he wants to see the child image as well as his father image also. So now if he wants to see his bottom side, then the light rays should come from the bottom and it should be incident on the mirror. The light rays which are going to be incident on the mirror, the light rays which are going to be incident on the mirror, that's going to be reflected to I. Now he is able to see the bottom side. If he wants to see the top of the top side, and the light ray should come from the top of the person and it should be incident on the mirror and those should be reflected to I. Now he is able to see his father also. So these are the conditions which we know. Now extend this one. Now actually what we have to find is, what is the minimum length of the mirror that requires? So what is the minimum length of the mirror that requires to see his image as well as his father's image? So now this is going to be the length of the mirror that is possible to see his image as well as his father's image also. So now let's see that. This is the height of the person. If we extend this one, so this is the height h. From here to here it is h. From here to here it is h. And from here to here it is remaining h because the father height is 2h. So now, as this is incidenting equally, means that whatever this angle should be same. Means that glancing angles are going to be same. Means that this is going to be h by 2. Obviously, this is also going to be h by 2. Because the glancing angles are same and their sides also should be same. So this is h by 2 and this is h by 2, totally this total length is going to be h because our child height is h. So is it clear? Now, as we said, from here to here this total length is h. If we consider this is x, then what about this one? It's going to be h minus x. So now, the minimum length of the mirror that requires to see his image as well as his father's image is x plus h by 2. So now we already know the h by 2 value. If we are able to find out the x value, then we can find the minimum length of the mirror, right? Yes. Now consider the similar triangles. Let's suppose this is A and this is B and this is C and this is D and this is E and this is F. So now what are the similar triangles that we are going to consider? Consider the triangles from triangle ABC, and another triangle is D, it is what, F, this is G. Now we are going to consider the triangle DGC. This is one triangle and another triangle is ABC is the another triangle. So by consideration of those two triangles, what we get is AB. For AB side, parallel side is DG. That equals to BC. For BC side, parallel side is CG. So now we will find out AB length. What is the AB length? From here to here it is H plus H, 2H. By DG length. DG length from here to here it is h. What is the value of BC? That is h minus x. By CG, that is x. H get cancelled out by doing the cross multiplication. 2x equal to h minus x. Send this x into this side. and we will get the h value. Minus x when it comes this side, 3x equals to h. Actually, we have to find out the x value. Then x equals to h by 3. So now, as we said, if we know the x value, then we can find out the minimum length of the mirror. That is from E of G H. Let's consider this is P. So now, our required mirror length is C to P. Our required mirror length is CP. Means that CP equals to what? X plus H by 2. What is the value of X, ma? H by 3 plus H by 2. Now the LCM is 6, 3. 2 times 2. 3 times. So the answer is going to be 5 H by 6. This is the required answer.